cities or in villages, we are surrounded by several plants, many of which are edible. It's just that we don't recognize which these are. If we were to forage around our neighborhood, we'd find several of these are surprisingly great for our diet and can be used as leafy green vegetables. For example, one of the plants that can be eaten is something called talinum, or also known commonly as Ceylon spinach. It's grown for its pretty pink flowers usually, but the leaves are also edible. They are long in shape and they are a rich source of vitamins and minerals. They are high in oxalic acid, so it's best eaten cooked rather than raw. You can make a soup out of it, you can make a vegetable out of it, or it can also be cooked with dal. Drumstick or moringa, now touted as a superfood, is a very commonly visible tree growing all around Goa. We normally eat the long, slender pods as drumsticks, but the leaves and the flowers are also edible. The leaves are a very rich source of vitamin C, and it can be used as a vegetable, cooked, it can be used in dal, and it can be used as a substitute for anything in which you would use the regular palak. If you're looking for something high in fiber, then sweet potato leaves are an excellent choice. Normally, this is grown and eaten for the roots, but the leaves, if they're stir-fried with a little bit of garlic, put in a little soy sauce, it makes for an excellent side dish. You could also make a soup or a stew out of it and throw it into any dal to just perk up the flavor and get an extra dose of beta carotene. Bohinia, also known as the orchid tree or camel's foot, is a surprising discovery. It's not commonly known to be an edible plant, but the tender leaves and the buds, the unopened buds, sometimes even the flowers, can actually be sautéed to make a very tasty side dish. Tendli is a popular vegetable in Goa. This plant is grown for the little gourd that you see and is often used either as a pickle or to make a bhaji. But it may surprise you to know that the tender leaves that can be harvested from this plant can be used to make a curry, can be used to make a vegetable in its own, and can also be used for soups and for stews. And last but not least, purslane. The humble plant that is found outside most doorsteps with pretty flowers that open and close through the day. This is actually a plant that's really high in vitamin E and vitamin C. This is one of the plants that can be eaten raw in a salad. It can also be stir-fried or made into soups or stews. The stems, the leaves and the flowers are all edible. These are just a few examples of some of the plants that are found around the neighborhood and are edible. There are many, many more that can also be eaten. A few things to keep in mind as you go around foraging in your neighborhood. Remember, harvest only as much as you need. If you take too much, you could kill the entire plant. And the most important thing is that you must be 100% certain you know what it is you're eating. If you misidentify, you could end up falling seriously ill, as some of these plants can be toxic. Do not pick plants if you suspect the soil that they grow in are contaminated. It could be harmful for your health. And lastly, if you're picking from a neighbor's garden, it's always polite to ask.